Hello guys and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to see how to play dice streams on PC. Here you can watch it on screen. We will be able to easily download and install dice streams and enjoy playing this game on the Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's go. First of all buddies, to start we have to open our favorite web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can see on the screen. You don't need to type anything, because I added a link in the video description and the first main comment. We arrived at this point on our own website of Usitility, where we have an in-depth description on how to obtain dice streams on computer. We browse lower a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on that link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to play dice streams on PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of advantages of using this emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the dice streams by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on this button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. What we are going to do now is to run the installer, so we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I reduce the web browser to find the installer better. The installer is very easy to use. It contains two options, install and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path does. We merely click it. And now we realize that they got here the path in which the emulator will be installed. If we need to change this directory, we have to click on this browse option, and we choose another directory and install the emulator where we choose. To keep it simple, just set it by default. Then, I click on back. So I just click on install. Voila! The install commences and it's going to continue with the download of these megabytes that are represented on that computer screen. When you download it, it may be a little more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate could go at a higher speed or slower, determined by your web access and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Right now they are progressing quite fast. The download is finished, then at present it continues with the installation phase. The installation will take more or less time based on the power of your hard drive. The more powerful it is, the shorter the setup time and vice versa. If we integrate the download and install stage, it may take a considerably long time, so be patient. It is now finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has actually been started immediately. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right and when it actually reaches the end, the emulator will be started for the very first time. The fact is the emulator has been started, here for the first time. Before we carry on, as now you can see, it has made two icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is the one we are concerned about. Whenever we want to run dice streams on our PC, we twice click that icon and therefore start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything like that. In fact, it is an app icon that we may quite likely never use. Why don't we conduct the next phase? That is a must, and that is to enter the Google Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is presented. At this point we must sign in. At this time once we're there, we must do the next step which is compulsory. Therefore we mouse click on, sign in. At this moment it announces, checking info. It could in some cases get stuck in, checking info, and it doesn't move forward. If that's the case, you may attempt to log in and after a few hours and it will most certainly be fixed. At this moment we can provide our email and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For instance, you make use of the same email you are using at the moment in your YouTube account. So that I will submit my information and I'll return immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, info typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We are going to accept all of them simply by clicking, I agree. Following, it allows us to save to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked and it'll create a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and immediately. To install the game, we have to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking that app icon marked in green. Today that we are discovering the desktop of that Android emulator, we see that we have here the install game button. We simply click on that button. Right here we come with the game app. Let's quickly click on here on the install option that I'm highlighting now in green color. Therefore, it will launch the software installation. At present, it will download on your PC and install the game. It might take a little while, or it could also be very fast. It all will depend on the internet connection. This has as of now ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific button that I am highlighting in green, to be able to launch Dice Dreams for the first time. Let me click or double click on this My Games option above. We're currently on the emulator desktop, then we're going to click on this new Dice Dreams icon which has been generated. This game app is started for the first time. There we have it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the sound level of this emulator. It is here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we are not going to rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. That is simply the very first one. We just click on this icon that I am actually pointing out in green color. Then the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Assuming that we choose to play the video game in full screen, we click on this icon. And we might presently be experiencing the game in full screen mode. To exit the full screen setting, click the F11 key. And then we would definitely currently end up being in normal screen mode. At this moment I am on the way to explain you the computer keyboard mapping which is extremely interesting. This strategy we may be ready to use the game more easily. The first task is to mouse click this software icon. And here you will have the ability to complete the required configurations. I am going to keep the default configuration, however if you choose to improve it, you can do it with no problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our own language. In some cases it happens that the emulator is launched in the wrong language, for example, in Japanese. And therefore to set it up in the proper language we go here to the cogwheel. Then right here throughout additional settings, we click on the language drop down. We can also choose the language we want, Italian, Japanese, and so forth. Once the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator would restart, as well as the game app. Next time we run it, will also be in the specified language. At present, you can find another thing that we will need to take into account, and it is that we will receive an email saying that a brand new machine has been connected with our Google account. It will ask us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yup, we shouldn't be troubled, since the emulator is behaving like an Google Android electronic device. In order to determine which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. And so we browse here to the model selection. And right here we discover that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our training. I hope you liked it, particularly that you found it handy. In that case, bring it a good like, subscribe to the channel, and I will be happy to answer your comments, requests or ideas, put them in the comment box down below. You also can leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every once in a while, you have it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Mouse click on any of those videos that are appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming instructional videos. Bye.